Julia Boorstin, Senior Media and Entertainment Reporter for CNBC. Today at NBCU Academy, I'm going to talk about how to conduct live TV interviews. For my beat at CNBC, I cover big media, social, and internet companies, and I talk to a lot of CEOs of companies, both big and small. A lot of the time, I'm interviewing these CEOs live on the air. I've come up with a couple of tips that I find helpful no matter who I'm interviewing. Number one, do your homework. That means studying up on the topic in a broad sense, but also knowing anything related that's happening that week or certainly the day of the interview. And you'll want to be familiar enough with the details. That could be numbers, statistics, or technical terms, so you can comfortably use all of that information in your questioning. You should also research what the person has said in the past and what other people have said about them. Take a look at how I pressed WarnerMedia chief Ann Sarnoff on how she handled the decision to release their movies in theaters and on HBO Max at the same time. I want to ask you to respond to that criticism of Christopher Nolan and some other big Hollywood names. And I'm wondering if you think this is going to make it really hard for you to negotiate with top talent, both in front of and behind the camera.
Well, look, I mean, we are big, big fans of the exhibitors. We have been great partners with them, including in seeing Chris Nolan's movie Tenet this summer. We had a great partnership with the theaters, and we were very happy with the release.
Number two, be ready to ask follow-up questions so you can get better answers. Doing your homework beforehand is important for many reasons, but one main reason is that it makes you comfortable enough with the topic so that during the interview, you can really focus on listening to what the person says. Really listening will allow you to go back to certain points to ask clarifying questions so the audience can really understand. It also enables you to press that person by rewording or repeating your question when they're not giving you a real answer. When I interviewed Disney CEO Bob Chapek, I asked him about competition. When he evaded my question, I pressed him on it. Do you think that that launch puts you more into competition with the likes of an HBO Max as it expands internationally and makes it more of a general entertainment play rather than really focusing on that family content?
Yeah, I would say it's a universal entertainment play. You know, our whole business is steeped in our core franchises, Pixar, Disney, Marvel, Lucas, across the board.
And so who do you think is your main competition, both here in the U.S. and abroad?
Well, you know, when you talk about competition, I think, you know, Disney sort of stands by itself.
Number three, be flexible and change your plans when you need to. You should go into an interview with specific questions you feel like you definitely need to get answered. That's why I like to start with the most timely or important questions first. But always listen very closely to the responses, because sometimes the person will say something that makes you decide that in the moment it's best, it's more newsworthy to change plans, to drop your questions and really to dive into what they just said, or sometimes, more importantly, what they didn't just say. Now keep in mind too that especially in live interviews, you have a limited amount of time. So you want to make sure that you're the one in the command of the interview, and you shouldn't hesitate to drive the conversation from one point to the other, changing subjects as necessary. So when I interviewed Snap CEO Evan Spiegel, I wanted to make sure that he addressed the elephant in the room, which was Facebook, even if he didn't want to. So I just kept asking him about it. To go back to my first question, which was about competing with Instagram. Instagram is, of course, owned by Facebook, and Facebook, on many different counts, has copied some of your most successful features. How do you think about competing with this behemoth?
Well, the strategy that's worked for us is just to continue innovating and leading the way and trying to really serve our community.
The most recent copycat move we saw from Facebook was Instagram Threads, taking some of the most appealing parts of your communications and creating an entirely new app around it for Instagram users to communicate. What do you think of that app?
You know what, I actually haven't had a chance to try it out.
So you're doing a good job of not mentioning Facebook, not using the word Facebook.
Well, I think for our designers it's very inspiring because it means that the work that they do, the things that they create, get an even broader audience.
So do you think Facebook's behavior is anti-competitive?
I think there are some things that they've done in the past, you know, that they could be perceived to be anti-competitive. Things like, you know, limiting the reach of other, you know, services on their platform, preventing people from using a snap code in their profile or something like that. And I think, you know, services that have, you know, reach as broad as Facebook are held to a different standard, obviously. So I think, you know, we'll sort of see what happens over time.
In my years of doing live interviews, I found that I could be most confident and able to pivot midstream and best able to think on my feet when I'm the most prepared. I love walking into an interview knowing that I could put down my notes and just be in the moment. Once it starts, I tune out all distractions and I just laser focus in on two things: what the interview subject is saying and the time cues from the control room. In that 5 or 10 minutes, nothing else exists. I hope you can come to love doing live interviews as much as I do. And so this is what I hope you'll take away from this video. Do your homework before, listen carefully so you can ask follow-up questions, make sure you get the best answers possible on the topics everyone is wondering about, but also be flexible, pick up on new leads, and don't be afraid to drop your plan if the situation calls for it. I'm Julia Boorstin for NBCU Academy. Thanks for joining us.